Sir, here now crop production and management. In this lesson, as in the last period, we learnt about the seed drill and also about the manures and fertilizers. Now, next one point is there, that is about the irrigation. What is irrigation? As you know, plants or living organisms need the water. Water is very much essential for the plants. As without water, plants are growing. Seed germination is there. That is taking place with the help of water only. So dry, when it is dry, seed germination also not taking place, and water is very much necessary for the growth of the all plants. In the water, there is a manure, fertilizers, minerals through the soil are mixing, and that is absorbing by the root of the plants. Means everywhere without water, plants are not growing. So this water, it is plants how they are not able to hear. Grow without the water. Nutrients dissolved in water are transported to the each part of the plant, and then that water, as you know, you learnt about the photosynthesis also in the last year. So in the photosynthesis process also water is essential. The water reaches up till the leaves, and the leaves chlorophyll pigments are present there. Photosynthesis process with the help of water taking place. So food, plants are preparing their own food. That time water is a here raw material, very much essential. To maintain the moisture of the soil for healthy crop growth, field have to be watered regularly. So the crops, farmers are growing the crops in the field, that time water is very much necessary. If water want to grow the different variety of the plants, crops, that time proper supply of water is necessary. So now the next point is there, that is about the irrigation. What is irrigation? That is the supply of water to the crops at a regular interval. At a regular interval means at regular time there is a supply of water, that is called as a irrigation. Proper supply of water for the crop plants at a regular interval, time to time we are supplying the water with the help of a irrigation. So here the time and frequency of irrigation varies from crop to crop. Some crops need a more percentage of water, some need a less percentage. And soil to soil also, some soil has the ability to store the water in them. But some means they have a holding water holding capacity is there for some soil. See, here water ability is there. Regular interval of a time, how we are supplying, it's a time duration is important. That is and also it varied from crop to crop. Which type of a crop, some crops need a more amount of water, some crops need less amount of water. Soil to soil, there is some soil has a ability to upper holding the water, some soil has a less ability. And here it also depend season to season, because rainy season need not that much not need a water supply. And also there is a means depend on the season, and also in a summer season it needs a more percentage of the water. Here now, irrigation proper supply of water. Sources of irrigation, which are they? If farmers are supplying the water, which are the sources of water? As you know, there is the pond, lake, river, wells, which are nearby available, bore wells, tube wells are available for them. So, these are the sources of the water for the crops. There are the traditional methods of irrigation. The water is available in a lakes, water, wells, river. That can be lifted by the different methods. That is the traditional methods are there. Some are there traditional for taking the water or supplying the water for the field. Cattle or human labor is there. They are using traditional method. What is it? In the traditional method, there are the cattle or humans as a labors, they used up for these methods for the here lifting the water. So these methods are cheaper but less efficient. But that is not that these methods are there, traditional methods are there. Cheaper one with the help of a human, otherwise animals here help cattle will help. That is the traditional method for the lifting water. They are cheaper but not that much efficient one. Means that is that much it is not working it for the huge amount of crop areas are there. If more field is big field are there available for that it is not suitable. So less efficient. The various traditional ways are there. They are the diagrammatic representation available. See, moat is there. there. So here with the help of a motor, the human labor is there, they will use there and water supply for the crop field. Next one, chain pumps are there. With the help of a chain pumps for the wheel, there are the chains are there, pumps are there, and with the help of that water will lifting. Next one, here decally is there. So decally is also another method with the help of the, here there is as we are observing in the picture that here any bucket or any vessel is there tying for the here with the help of a wood thread, and then they are lifting that water, that is a decally. Next one is there, means stone is attaching, stone is a binding for that for the wood, and then that it will lift the water with the, that is called as a decally. And next one is there, that is rahat, with the help of animals. You are seeing many times animals are moving, and with the help of that wheel is rotating, and that is called as when wheel is rotating, the water will come up, lift up, and that is called as a rahat. So these are the traditional method, that is moat system, pulley system, that is called chain pumps are there. Next, third one is a decally, and fourth one is the rahat. Pumps are commonly used for the lifting the water. As you know, nowadays we are using motor pumps, different types of motors are using, like that pumps are mostly commonly used for the here lifting the water. Diesel, biogas, electricity and solar energy is used to run these pumps. So pumps are how they are used, they help up electricity, like otherwise different fuels are there, diesel is there, they will use biogas with the help of cow buffalo dung, there is a formation of a biogas, because in the field it is mostly going to do that one. And electricity, solar energies are there, with the help of that they will run the pumps. Modern methods of irrigation. There are the two modern methods here. Modern methods of irrigations are there. They are nothing but the sprinkler system and drip system. Sprinkler irrigation. What is a sprinkler irrigation? Sprinkler. Here, water is a sprinkling in the field. The sprinkling system is there. It is a present in the area, means in the dry region where water is less available, not more availability of water is there. This system is useful the uneven and land where sufficient water is not available. In that, it is suitable one. Perpendicular pipes having a rotating nozzles are there. These nozzles are there here. There are the nozzles are present. They are rotating and there is a sprinkling of water everywhere. It is taking place on the top. And are joined a main pipeline at regular intervals. Main pipeline is present in between the two pipes. So like this arrangement is there, and there is a sprinkling system of the water is there. When water is allowed to flow through the main pipe under pressure with the help of pump, it escape from the rotating nozzles, and rotation of that nozzles are there, and it will here sprinkling of that water is taking, get sprinkled on the crop, and if it is like a raining. Sprinkling is useful for the lawns, coffee plantations and several other crops where means less amount of water is sufficient, water is not available in that area, it is suitable, that is a sprinkler irrigation. Next one, drip irrigation. In the drip irrigation, here in the system water falls drop by drop on the root of the plants. Means here if any plants are there, like it is suitable for the here fruits are there, otherwise different types of again crops are there, for that water is a falling drop by drop in that area only on the root of the crop. So like these systems are available, that is called as a sprinkle here drip irrigation. This is a drip irrigation. Water is a here providing to the root of that plants. So it is called as drip system. It is best technique for watering the fruit plants, gardens also, and also the different trees. Water is not wasted here at all, and it is one boon in a regions where availability of water is poor, because here water wastage is very less. Directly the water is reaching for that plants directly here for the root. Next one, protection from the weeds. Bhujan Valley went to a nearby wheat field and saw there were some other plants in the field growing along with wheat plants. As you are observing many times when we are moving on the road, different fields are observing. In the field we are observing there is a wheat is there, otherwise groundnuts are there, jawar is there, sugarcane is there, they are growing. With that other plants, grasses are there, congress grass is there. which are not useful, that type of plants are growing, and that are called as weeds. So the next point is there, that is protection from weeds. So here, what are the weeds? In a field, many other undesirable, which are not useful plants may grow naturally along with crop. Along with crop, they are growing. Naturally, they are growing. Like a grass, Congress grass, they are growing here, and that are unuseful, undesirable one. And so these plants are undesirable plants are called as a weeds. The removal of weeds are called as a weeding. As you know, many times by hand also they are removing. When saplings will come, small plants are growing, that time in that and also when here means plants are growing, in between that there is a weeding is going to take place. The weeds removing is called as weeding is necessary because here there is a competition for the crop, for the mineral, nutrients, water, for the space, light. For that purpose, they are fighting. Means competition is there. If here are the different here wheat, otherwise jawar is growing. In between that, there are the different grasses or different plants which are not useful. Weeds are growing. Then what will happen? They will compete for the water, mineral, nutrients which we are providing for the crops. They are competing there. For the wheat, if we are providing here fertilizers, manures, then there is a they will compete for that. They will absorb that mineral nutrients. Means proper nutrients, minerals are not reaching for the crops, for the field. They are absorbing by the weeds. So it is necessary to remove that weeds. That is, weeding is necessary. For space and light, they will compete here. Thus, the effect of a growth of the crops, some weeds interferes even harvesting and may be poisonous for animals and human beings. So sometimes during harvesting, they will grow and they will enter, that seeds are there, and they are sometimes poisonous for the animals which are eating that one leaves, because they are the weedicide, undesirable one. So they are poisonous for some animals and also even sometimes for the human beings. Farmers adopt many ways to remove the weeds and control their growth. They will control their growth by weedicides are using. Tilling before sowing of crops help in uprooting and killing of the weeds. You know, we learnt about the here plowing. That time we learnt about the tilling and here tilling. That is the loosening and turning of the soil. When plow is there, that plowing done, that time loosening and turning of the soil taking place, that time it is called as a tilling. It will remove the or uprooting of the weeds going to take place, which is may dry up and get mixed with soil. The best time for removal of weeds before they produce a flowers and seeds. Always weeds will remove, but when they will grow before the producing a flowers and seeds. Otherwise, their number is increasing, and so you should remove that one before they are producing flowers and the seeds. And the manual removal includes a physical removal weeds by uprooting, cutting them close to the ground from time to time. So manually removing, otherwise cutting them from close to the soil, and it is a time to time necessary. This is done with the help of khurpi. A seed drill is also used for uproot weeds. Sometimes seed drill is using for uprooting the weeds. We learnt about the seed drill. That time I told about the cultivator also. So who that they are using for the removing of the weeds. Also by the here manually it is able to do. Weeds are controlled by using certain chemicals, that weedicides. Farmers are using weedicides. When they will spray the weedicides, it will control the growing of the weeds. 2,4-D example is there for the weedicides, that is weedicide, that is a 2,4-D is there. That 2,4-D here, it is an example for weedicide. They sprayed in the field to kill the weeds. So for killing of the weeds, it is taking place with the help of weedicide. They do not damage the crop, and weedicides are diluted with water to extent and are required here for diluting with water extent required sprayed in the field with a sprayer. With a sprayer, they will spray here. Nowadays, you know that you are observing that we are using different sprays for the controlling the germs, viruses. So by the dilution of that, like a Dettol we are using for controlling the coronavirus, like that here controlling of the weedicides means 2-4-D is the example for that. That concentration is more in the small bottle, it will come. So what will they do? That is mixing, diluting with water and mixing with water, and then they are sprinkling everywhere in the field with the help of a sprayer. As already mentioned, weedicides are spread during the vegetative growth of weeds before flowering. Before flowering or before producing seeds, it is necessary to spray the weedicides. Spraying of weedicide may affect the health of a farmer, so they should be use these chemicals very carefully, because it is very stronger one. Weedicides are chemicals. It is necessary to wear the mask here, and here it is affecting on the nose and mouth. Covering of a cloth is very much necessary, because weedicide is one of the chemical, it is a poisonous one, and it will affect for the farmer. So carefully that farmers are handling it. Next one point is there, that is about the harvesting. What is harvesting now? Harvesting of a crop is an important task. Now see here, preparation of soil is over. After that, that is the seeds growing. After that, manure fertilizers. Then irrigation, providing water properly, then protection from the weeds and means undesirable plants are there, that one removing from the field. This is now harvesting. It is a here very important task. The cutting of a crop after it is called as a manure. Now crop growth or growth of the plants are there, complete over, means wheat is there, jawar field is there, complete growth of the crop is there here, proper one. So the cutting of crop after the here, it is mature, maturity of a plant is over, they produce the seeds now, and now we want to cut it, that is called as a harvesting. In harvesting, crops are pulled or cut out close to the ground. Now means here how it is taking place, see. Here, if any plants are growing, in that there is a, now if any wheat or grass is there, wheat or jawar is there, wheat is there or jawar is there, in that they will cut it from the here near region, they will cut with the help here from the near the ground region. In harvesting, crops are cut close to the ground. It is usual takes 3 to 4 months for a cereal crop to mature. So after 3-4 months, the season or maturity of the crop when completing, the farmers are there, they will cut it, otherwise pull it out that plant, and that is removing of the seeds or removing of the crop from the field, that is a here harvesting. Harvesting in our country is either done by manually or by the sickle. We saw the sickle, like a khurpi it is, and by sickle or by a machine called as a harvester. So sometimes they will do it either manually, in small field are available, they will do it manually, otherwise with the help of a sickle, otherwise harvesting machines are there. So that is the here by the called as a harvester. In the harvested crop, the grain seeds need to be separated from the chaff. So here grain seeds are there, you know that you are observing, like a green peas are there, otherwise jawar wheat is there, that it is necessary in the harvesting crop, seeds need to be separate from the chaff, and this process is called as a threshing. You learnt about the threshing process in the last year, in the here 7th standard also. So whenever the plants are there, in that like this like structures are there, in that seeds are available, like these seeds are available, seeds want to remove by the threshing method, means that plants are there, crops are taking and beating that one, that is called as threshing. This is carried out with the help of machine or called a combine, and which is in fact harvester as well as the thresher. So there is a machine is there, after the harvesting there is a machine is there, that is called as a combine. Yeah, harvester is also present, means here there is a machine called combine, which in fact harvester as well as the here threshed is present in that. It will cut from the ground of the plants, and also seeds are separating from that chaff, and here then there is the seeds are separating. So this is carried out with the help of a machine that is called as combine. In that harvester come thresher is present. Farmers with a small holdings of a land do the separation of a grain and chaff by the winnowing. If small field is there, this method is there, they are going to do with the help of winnowing also. So winnowing is the method, like from the big area, what will they do here? When wind is blowing, the grains are there falling on the ground, the heavy grains are will fall here, and the lighter grains are there, they will move. So lighter one is there, whatever the dust is there, whatever the leaves, stalks are there, they will remove from that grains. So grains are falling here. So that is the here. This method is called as a winnowing. Next one method is there, that is about the storage. So after the harvesting, storage is there. Storage of a produce is an important task. So when farmers are growing any variety of the crops in the field, that storage of the crop, because yearly that whatever the crops will grow, we have to store it. So population, production, crop production we are learning. Crop production over, but management and distribution of that food, it is very much necessary. So storage crops are there here. That with the help of a crop production and management, as we are observing, management and the distribution of the crop field is there. It is very much necessary. If the harvested grains are to be kept for a longer time, because as here seasonally some grains are there, or some types of crops are there that we are growing, like a wheat, jawar is there, we are taking that one seasonally, it will not come in all season. So we have to here grains that keep for a longer time. They should be safe from the moisture, insect, rats and microorganisms. So rodents are there, moisture is there, insects are there. So here it is necessary protect them from that all. They should be safe from the moisture. Some in a rainy season more moisture is present. It is necessary to keep it properly, and also from the insects, rats, rodents are there, microorganisms are there. They will attack on that. They will eat that grains. So storing is very much important part after the harvesting. Harvested grains have more moisture. If freshly harvested grains are stored without drying. So here harvested grains are there, they have a more moisture is there. Freshly harvested grains don't store. It is necessary to dry it first of all. Whatever freshly harvested grains are there, in that more moisture is present. Without drying, it is not storing any time. They may get spoiled and attacked by the organisms. So insects are there, microorganisms are there, making them unfit of a use, and also for the germination purpose. Hence, before storing them, grains are properly dried to the sun. So as I told, it is drying of that grains are very much necessary before the storing. After the harvesting, the grains are drying in the sun, and to reduce the moisture of them, and this prevent attack by the insect, pest, bacteria and fungi are there. It will prevent. Farmer stores the grain in jute bags or metallic bins. Jute bags are there, in that they are storing that one. Otherwise metallic bins are there, big, in that they will store. Large scale storage grains are there is done in the silos, and gunneries are there in them. They are going to silos for the storage of the grains, as you are observing in the diagrammatic representation. Storage of grains in the gunny bags also, in the godowns you are observing many times. That is called as a gunneries, to protect them from the pest like rats, rodents, insects, microorganisms from them. Dried neem leaves are used for the storing food grains at home. So there are the dried leaves are there. Well, like a neem leaves are there. Your mother is there when storing the grains like a wheat, jawar, grams. She will use sometimes neem leaves. That dried leaves of the neems are there, mixing with them. Means any here insects are there. Otherwise microorganisms, fungi are there, not attacking on them. For storing large quantity of grains, big godown, specific chemical treatments are required to protect from the pest and microorganisms. So here, this is about the here. here how to store the crop after the production, that is a production after the crop. So irrigation, protection from the weeds, harvesting and storage. Next, food from the animals. Here you are observing, you know that many types of food, like a milk is there, one of the food which is very much necessary always in everybody's home. We depend on the cow, buffalo, sheep, goats, camels in them for the milk purpose. We depend, we are using that milk, means animal husbandry. In that here animals food which we are using, like meat is there, egg is there from the hen, meat is there, here we are using, like fishes are there. So these are the different type of production of the animals, food from the animals we are using it, that is animal husbandry. Like plants, animals also provide a different kind of food. How plants are providing, like that animals are also providing. Many people living in the coastal area, they consume the fish. Fishes are important for them, they are eating the fish. And so here there is a diet, part of a diet in them, that is a fishes. In the previous class you learnt about the here how food obtained from the plants. Now we have just seen the process of a crop production involves here and management of that and storage of that and how to distribute it. Now similarly, animals reared at home for the in farms. So animals, many times different animals are there. So that animals are there, they are rearing like a domestic animals. Cow, buffaloes are there. Also there is a sheep, goats, sheeps are there, goats are there, and camels are there. They are rearing, that are called as a domestic animal. Hen is there. So here with the, from them getting a food, the different kinds of food we are using of them. So animals reared at home and also are in a farms in a big area have to be provided with a proper food, shelter and care. And when this is done in a large scale, when for the large scale, you know, pisciculture, fishes are here caring or here that are transporting, that is called as a pisciculture. Culture of that animals or rearing of the animals for the large scale. Now cow buffaloes in a farmer's in a home, for one or two cows or buffaloes are there. But in a large scale, when we are rearing that one and we are providing the milk for the dairies, then it is called as a large scale, that is called as an animal husbandry. So, and also about the egg also, you know that many time poultries are there, big, that is also a animal husbandry. Sericulture is there, here culture of the silk. So these are the different varieties are there in the animal husbandry. So this is about the crop production and management lesson. You prepare this lesson properly and this lesson is there for your first achievement test. So all of you, all the best for your test.